You're watching the Self-Determination Channel. On today's episode of In the Spotlight, Cindy and I are going to talk about job coaches. A job coach gives extra help to a worker as they learn how to do their job.
Job coaches also can help support the employer. Ashley and I put together some ideas for job coaches.
You can share these ideas with your job coach. Or better yet, watch these videos with your job coach and talk about ways you can best work together.
Let's get started.
Communication is key. We might not know what questions to ask or how to share what we are struggling with. Take time to ask questions and talk to us. Communication is key because otherwise you don't know what someone's feeling that day. Maybe they're emotional or maybe they're upset about something or maybe they're having a bad sensory issue, and you can come up with strategies so that it goes smoothly at work and that it doesn't go badly.
Just don't assume that I'm understanding everything you're saying, and also don't assume and use big words. Keep it simple, ask questions. If this is okay, can I do this? Just don't assume that you're gonna swing something by me. I need to be communicated so I know what I'm expected of me.
If you think that the person's not understanding, then ask them, how can I do this differently?
Yeah.
That's my complete advice to you guys right now.
Use a calm voice when giving directions. You know, we're not getting it just the way you want to. The more calm you are, the more you're going to get out of the person. What do you think, Ashley?
When you're mad and when you're angry, it's not going to be communicated well. And then you could have a situation like a meltdown to occur. Then if you have to, take a deep breath and then talk to them. Use an enthusiastic voice / calm voice because a lot of people deal with things that we don't know of, and we always just have to be kind.
Be clear and say what you mean.
A lot of people with disabilities have a hard time kind of knowing what people say and what they mean by different tones, different facial expressions, different things you say. So your looks, your tone, everything that you say matters.
Ashley's right. I've been in that situation where the job coach will say to me, I'm going to be there in 15 minutes. And don't get there for 30 minutes. So I'm waiting and getting anxious and everything. Just tell me the facts. Provide feedback in a private place, not in front of other coworkers or customers. I'll just say is that it embarrasses me.
People with disabilities are just like everyone else. They want to be treated with respect, so I encourage you to treat them with respect. If a meltdown takes place, do not say get over it. Let it happen, then brainstorm ways to prevent it in the future. They are sometimes going to occur, so just being very cautious and nice and figuring out strategies and saying, how can I help you, instead of, you know, you're such a pain, you have meltdowns every day. I mean, that's not nice. Just think about what you say before you say it.
Let's talk about how we can work together. On the first day, it is helpful to get a tour of the workplace. Introduce us to our coworkers so everyone gets to know each other. So we start off on the right foot.
It's important to have a tour because you want to be familiar with your coworkers, the surroundings, all that stuff, so you don't get so anxious when you get into the job. I encourage you to have a tour of your workplace. Good job coaches don't get in the way of the boss or coworkers.
I think it's important that we have natural support of the coworkers and the boss.
Job coaches, they should be invisible in the setting. And if you need them, then you have them. They're supposed to blend in. If you need help, you should really be going to a coworker and asking for help. So I encourage you to talk to your coworkers first to get help and then go to the job coach, because that's just part of starting to fade, which we'll talk about later. Good job coaches don't overhelp or socialize with the person they are coaching. This gets in the way of developing a bond with new coworkers. One, you're supposed to be working, not socializing with your job coach. And they're supposed to be doing their job and you're supposed to be doing your job. And overhelping, either the person's going to get mad, number one, or number two, they're going to keep on relying on you to do it for them.
Yeah, I think it's important that you keep things separate. If you're working with your job coach, just keep it at a professional level. And that's how it should be. That's what I would add. Both the job coach and the employee should be open-minded and learn from one another. We both have to listen to each other. I may have an idea, and the job coach may have an idea. So it is important to listen to both sides.
I think that it needs to be open communication, and don't be so stubborn that you don't want to listen from each other. Everybody should learn and grow from each other and collaborate. That's what I think. We hope that these ideas are helpful. In the next episode, we'll talk about qualities of a good job coach and fading. If you haven't already, be sure and subscribe and check on the bell icon. You'll be notified when we post the next video. We'll see you next time.